Hey guys, today we're going to find out, does rust form underneath undercoating? So where I live, it rains a lot. I live in Lower Mainland BC, and we're close to Seattle to give you an idea of what happens out here. Now, it's not to say it doesn't snow out here, but rain probably is going to give you a better idea of what's going to happen with your undercoating because the frame is constantly getting wet. If a vehicle's in snow all the time, salt, yes, is bad for it. Snow and everything can react with it, but when it's at freezing temperature, you're not going to get that kind of corrosion. It's when it all melts. So when it warms up and it melts, that's when the salt and the water is going to react with the metal. Typically, it's going to be steel on most vehicles. So in where I live, though, the frame is always wet. So that's why we took a longer time to make this video, is because we really wanted to get the frame soaked for over the years. And if there's a problem with moisture getting underneath the undercoating, then we're going to see it because we're always just getting this thing wet. The water has time to build its way into it, and the moisture has time to build itself into it, and we're going to see what happens.
So on your daily commute, if it looks really rainy like this, factor in that at these speeds, we're missing a lot of water. That water is hitting the frame and collecting everywhere on it.
So this is where the concern would be. After 30 minutes of driving daily, the frame gets soaked, and then the moisture can work its way into the undercoating and then cause corrosion.
So I've been waiting years to do this video because I wanted to give it more time and I wanted to really analyze what's going on in my truck and actually determine, is undercoating bad for the vehicle? So let's get right into it. This is a section that I did on the truck where I was talking about grounds, and there's grounds over here, and so many people were saying like, oh man, your frame's cracked, blah, blah, blah. Well, it was just undercoating. And then it got into huge discussions and people were like, oh, your truck's gonna rust from the inside out, blah, blah, blah. So let's take a look. I don't want to do this, by the way. So removing the undercoating, the factory GM wax. And you have beautiful, clean steel underneath.
So what happened? Why doesn't this truck look like a lot of the GMT 800s out there? Now, if you think about it, GMT 800s are pretty reliable and durable because there's still tons of them running around today, especially in my area. Now, a little bit background on my area. Live in Lower Mainland, BC, Vancouver, BC. So we're in Canada. It doesn't snow as much as, let's say, Alberta or Ontario, but we do salt a lot still because it gets quite icy here. That's why I wanted to wait, because it's not fair for me to compare a Lower Mainland Vancouver vehicle to one in Alberta, because one in Alberta goes through much harsher conditions. So I wanted to add, you know, another 6 years basically to prove that there is a way that you can make undercoating last long. So get undercoating, or I'll use this stone shield, which is rubberized. Now the argument is that when you put the membrane on, it can let go a little bit, then moisture works its way inside, and they can rust from the inside out. I actually 100% agree with that. So there's a trick I do. I rust-proof my vehicle twice a year. I'll use fluid film. So I'll spray fluid film right before winter, right before they start salting. I'll get my frame all goopy. And the reason is, if everyone says moisture will work its way inside and get trapped by the undercoating, if I spray something like this that can creep its way through things, well then the fluid film gets trapped underneath the undercoating and then we get results like this. So let's spray our stone shield. So I like the stone shield because it dries and it's paintable technically after. I don't paint it, but I just like the fact that it's dry to the touch. That way when I'm working on my truck, I don't get this tarry stuff all over me. So it's nice because you can just do quick spot repairs. So like if there's some markings that you scraped off when you're off-road or something, you can just go ahead and hit it. So this is the secret to make your undercoating last long. You're gonna be thorough and give it a nice coat. And you preferably want to do this when it's dry out. That way it can kind of give it time to soak itself in. That way when it starts to rain a lot, snow a lot, you're dealing with salted roads, you don't have to think about it anymore. I do an oil change when it starts to get cold, because that's usually when I hit about 5,000 kilometers, and then I will spray this on. Now I do not spray this on at the end of spring. I'll do it at the beginning of spring. So I'll desalt the vehicle, clean everything underneath, and then hit it with fluid film again. The reason I do it after winter is this is worn off, and then you might have a lot of salt residue, and then the salt wants to react with the steel. So I'll put this on to counteract it. Summertime, I do not do this. I'll just spray underneath the truck, clean it off. I do not want the fluid film in the summertime because we go camping and it's really dry out and we drive a lot of dusty roads. The dusty roads, this will stick to, dirt will stick to this, and then you have all this caked on mud and dirt underneath the truck. So there are pros and cons to using a product like this, so I just time it accordingly. Plus in the summertime, I'm not too concerned about salt or anything, so I don't need this kind of protection during that time. Let's verify inside the frame as well, so you can see that there's a healthy thickness in here. And you can see where it's a little, where it's kind of shiny, that's the residue from the rust inhibitor, the fluid film that we're spraying in there. So let's just go ahead and scrape this. So the wax part's coming right off. We see it's clean underneath. Again, here is like here, this is all original in the truck, 2005. And you're really looking for areas where things can build up. And the nice thing about this stuff is it's safe for plastic. So I don't care if it gets on connectors or things like that. But the problem with these ABS modules is they get covered in a lot of stuff and then they have tons of issues and it's a very expensive fix. And even though you might think like the repair's not that bad, downtime might cost you a lot if you use your truck for business or even just going to work. So we don't want any of that. It takes just a few minutes. So you can see this is where the truck got beat up a bit. So, but what I'm concerned about is inside. So those of you that have box frames, this is even more crucial because you can't see in here. It's very hard to clean out. So anywhere there's an access hole, I'll give it a good spray. And then we're just gonna spray over this rust. I'm not gonna put any undercoating in because we're going right into salt season basically. So I just wanna keep everything at bay. You guys check out my cab corners. You can see there's no issues with them. So we're gonna get in here and so one of those things, there's nothing you really do. Once it starts to rust, that's it. So taking the time to spray in here will give you a ton more life out of your truck. And again, don't spray undercoating in here. So I've shown you guys where if you're diligent, that this combination acts really well. Now I want to show you on the same truck where if you are negligent, what happens? Well, just like paint, edges are where it's going to be the weakest and it wants to fold up. So water and moisture can get trapped in there. So you can see here on this section, because I was negligent on this one part, I'm getting rust. So I'm just hitting with fluid film for now. I'm gonna have to grind this off. It's just a little bit of surface rust, but I'm gonna have to grind it off, put rust inhibiting paint, then a light coat of undercoating or the rocker guard, that way it doesn't wanna peel off. That was the problem is before in the early years of this truck, I would layer it. And I think that's a bad idea. Just a thin coat to coat the paint, or coat the metal just like paint, and then load up on the fluid film on a regular basis. So you can see on the exact same vehicle, the pros and cons and what you should and should not do. So when I'm done, this is what it looks like. So the frame is pretty goopy. Now, whether you run undercoating or not, your frame should be goopy if you live in areas where they salt the roads. This is how you're gonna get more life out of your truck or your car. So looking at it, this is how my truck has looked for the past 14 years. It's just black underneath, and then it'll get goopy, and then it'll go through the season, I'll wash it off, and then it's just black underneath. Maybe I have to touch some things up. But if you compare it to the average person, probably owns their vehicle. Nowadays, it seems like it's 3 years. It used to be 4 or 5. I like to see 10. If you can buy a used vehicle, fight depreciation, and own the vehicle for at least 10 years, you're not dumping a lot of money into your vehicle. You can spend your money on other investments. That's what I like to do, like tools or things to make you more efficient, or you know, property, whatever it may be. And doing things like this will keep the vehicle in service. You don't have to worry about it. And it's also a good time to do an inspection. Like you're under here, you're spraying a little bit, and then you're like, oh, what's that? Now, I will say, if you are not the one servicing your vehicle, let's say you bring it to a mechanic all the time, they're probably not going to like this. They're going to think like, oh, there's leaks everywhere, or it just gets really messy for them. So maybe get your servicing done first and then do this, or go to a technician or a mechanic that values you taking care of your vehicle like this. Well, there you guys have it. That's the secret that I have to making undercoating work properly on your vehicles. You still have to do a regular rust proofing once or twice a year. So what do you guys think? Would you do this? Do you already do something like this? Do you do something completely different? Or do you still think that the vehicle is going to rust from underneath, even though we scraped a bunch off of it? Comment below. I'd like to know.